Thank you. It's a little tight on stage. Well, we're really excited for tonight, and we have a really fun program and awards between everything. And this is all being recorded, so enjoy the concert. And we are going to get started with the Clovis High School Symphonic Band. And please help me welcome their director, Mr. Casey Boggs. At this time, we want to recognize our senior members in the program. And as we call their name, we're going to have them come up here. And each senior that is in our program will receive a fancy blue medal. On one side, it's this really cool band image. And on the other side has their name, their graduation class, and what they participated in. Every senior does that. It's a tradition, and we're happy to be able to do this live this year. Even last year was a little different, and the year before that was virtual, so we're just excited to be here. So as I call up your name, if you're a Symphonic fan, come on up here and stand right by the podium. Our first senior, please help me recognize Natalie Carrion. And then go stand by the podium so your parents can take pictures of you. Wow, this is everything you dreamt of. Our next senior, please help me welcome Dionico Gonzalez, also known as Dennis. Come on. He's like, wait, I'm a senior? Yes, you are. Can you believe that? And looking just like him, please welcome his twin brother, Javier Gonzalez. Moving on, the Mac Daddy of trumpets, please help me welcome Joshua Lizarraga as our senior. Our next senior, please help me welcome Dakota Morales. That's a cute haircut. I have not seen it. That's cute. Our next senior, please help me welcome Tyler Spalding. In our percussion section, please help me welcome Donovan Dean. Up next, Madeline Lovejoy. And our last senior in this ensemble, please help me welcome Tarina Saiho. Let's give a big round of applause to our Symphonic Band seniors. Smile for your parents, twins, not even.
I think we pulled it for orchestra. Rebecca, oh, let's welcome Rebecca, but she's in orchestra too. I think I left her for next week. Rebecca, get up here. Rebecca plays the viola as well. Sorry, Becca, get up, move over a little closer. Becca plays viola as well, so next Tuesday she'll also be recognized. I'm sorry. They're gonna kick me off stage. All right, one more round of our applause to our Symphonic Band seniors. All right, let's take a seat.
All right. So our first plaque award, the following award is awarded to a person who constantly puts himself in situations to grow as a musician. He is volunteering during class and is willing to put himself out there. If I ask him to do something, the answer is always yes. And it's my pleasure to award the outstanding Symphonic Band member goes to Jacob Youngs. And our next award goes to a person who has really come into his own this year. He has been a solid figure in our trumpet section. He demonstrated a great work ethic during the entire marching season and carries himself with a quiet kindness that really is unmatched. It is my pleasure to award the Outstanding Brass Marcher Award to Chase Fung. And Chase is not here right now, but let's give him a big round of applause. Our next award goes to a person who has taken every challenge that has been thrown his way and always comes out on top. He always has a positive attitude and is a solid member of our front ensemble. His growth from marching band to concert season has been very fun to watch, and he is on his way to great things. Unfortunately, he isn't here tonight, but it is my pleasure to present the Percussion Rookie of the Year Award to Ethan Wolf.
Jacob wants a friend up there, don't you, Jacob? Yes. Your parents are loving this. Our next award is a very special award, near and dear to my heart. The Angel Quintero, who was a percussion student who left this earth too young. As a student, he would come up to you and touch you, and then he would say, "You've been touched by an angel." Angel was the core, heart, and the life of our percussion section. This year's recipient is the backbone of our percussion program. He has served our program for many years and is always willing to help. What I love most about this person is that no matter what kind of day it is, rough or smooth, he will always say thank you and share a smile. This gratitude is something that we as a staff treasure and reminds us all of why we do what we do. It is our pleasure to award the Angel Quintero Memorial Percussion Award to Donovan Dean. Let's give a big round of applause for our award recipients. All right, up next, they have prepared an incredible piece for you. Boys, you're more than welcome, unless you're still smiling, yes. Our next piece is Ancient Voices. Thank you. We have a really quick special presentation here. Is Sam here? Sam available? And I'm going to pass this microphone over to Sam Clark.
Okay, hi. I'm Sam Clark. I'm one of the seniors this year. And so basically, when we were all freshmen, like this graduating class, Mr. Boggs was a first-year teacher. So we're his first class of freshmen to, like, you know, have him see all 4 years. You know, that's cool, I guess. But also, I don't know how many people know this, because I only found out when Mr. Boggs told me, like, privately, but he got his master's degree this year in administration, which is, like, you know, a really big deal. You know, so he's getting his master's degree this year, and we're all graduating this year, so it's kind of like we're all graduating together. So we got him a little gift. They're going to come out here pretty soon with it. Oh, I'm so sorry. Yeah. So we all pitched in $2. Can we see you up here, please? So he really likes coffee, if you couldn't tell.
That's how I function.
Is this the right way? Yes. And then we made him a blanket, and we all put our handprints on it. From one class of 22 to another. Enjoy your master's degree.
Thank you.
This time we're going to do a quick transition to Wind Ensemble. Let's give another big round of applause to our symphonic band. And then symphonic band, I'm going to have you exit down by the flags. So to your left, take out rows 3 and 4. Wind Ensemble, you're going to come up to my right, your left, up these stairs. Any extra chairs or stands, we're going to put those away. Give us about a 2-3 minute quick change here.
Thank you.
looks like we're almost ready to go. As we get ready, I just want to take this time to acknowledge a few people that are instrumental in the administration of our program. I want to thank Dr. Emer O'Brien, our area super, or our district superintendent. Let's give her a big round of applause. Our area superintendent, Dr. Scott Dilley. Our Clovis High principal, Stephanie Hanks. I believe she is here, Mrs. Hanks. I just saw her backstage. Oh, she's in the back. Waving bye. Bye. Our LD over performing arts, Baljeet Gill. Mr. Gill, we like to call him Big G. And of course, all of our incredible parents, we want to thank you for everything that you do, and the students and our amazing team. So without further ado, I want to go ahead and get started with the next portion of our program. Our first piece is called Five on Five, and it is going to feature percussionist Eliana Kane, Addison Parker, Aspen Cervantes, Aiden Gomez, and Hannah Gonzalez. So here is Five on Five. To share with the percussion section, Dr. Dilley has informed us that there is money available, and we are going to be purchasing a whole new Yamaha line, so that should hopefully be coming in soon. Yeah. They got so excited. What does that mean? It just means a lot of new equipment coming, so you'll be hopefully seeing that whenever they arrive. Everything's on back order, but hopefully fall, no later than winter season, is our plan to have all new Yamaha equipment for the front ensemble. So if you see Dr. Dilley and Mrs. Hanks and Mr. Gill, please make sure we thank them for that lovely donation of upgrading a lot of our percussion equipment. Let's give them another big round of applause to our performers. This time, we're going to go ahead and move on to our, while we transition to our clarinet ensemble. Our clarinet ensemble we'll be playing Obladi Oblada. And I wasn't 100% sure if that was really the name of this title, because I thought it was Life Goes On, but I guess I was wrong. But what's really, really cool about this Beatles piece, it's arranged by one of our student clarinetists, Katie Collins, and it is being performed by Katie Collins, Jenna Johnson, Gavin Tapp, Kenshin Vang, Ever Vasquez, and Haley Webb. Oh, that's correct. So please help me welcome the Clovis High Clarinet Ensemble performing Obladi Oblada. Thank you, Clovis High Clarinet Ensemble. We are quickly going to transition over to our next percussion ensemble piece. Nickel, for your thoughts. Performing in this percussion ensemble, please help me welcome Austin Herr, Donald Bromwell, Eve Lice, well, oh my God, I'm so sorry, Eve. I'm so sorry. Maya Flattray, Liliana Morales, John Rickles, and Aiden Melton. Thank you. That was exciting. That's what they do in percussion class. I want to be in percussion class. All right. We have a few more awards and seniors we want to recognize at this time. I think we're just going to wait for this transition. Clarinet, you can come out. Our first senior that you just saw perform, please help me welcome onto the stage Eliana Kane. Oh, right over there, so your parents can take a picture of you. Yay. Our second senior, please help me welcome in our percussion section, Aspen Cervantes. And our last percussion senior, please help me welcome Austin Herr. And last but not least, one of these seniors is, each year, our instrumental music boosters give out 7 scholarships to deserving seniors in our program. While she is up here, we want to take the time to recognize our first recipient. Our instrumental music boosters have awarded a $500 scholarship for Outstanding Music Scholar to Eliana Kane. Congratulations, Ellie.
All right. Our next award goes to a person who has one of the highest standards for himself that I have ever seen. His commitment to excellence is truly inspiring to watch. He's extremely talented and will always put forth the maximum amount of effort for the good of the group. He isn't here, unfortunately, tonight, but it is my pleasure to award the Outstanding Marching Percussionist Award to Aiden Melton. The Percussion Director's Award is given to an individual for their dedication and positive attitude that is always on display. This person has given his all to this program. As a concert percussionist, he is always taking care of business and never disappoints. He has been a core member of our bass section and one of the leaders that many look up to in the ensemble. He carries himself with such a calm demeanor and has a solid work ethic that is always appreciated by the staff. It is my pleasure to award our Percussion Director's Award to Austin Herr. Let's give another big round of applause to these award winners. All right. And now we're going to transition to our wind ensemble, and their first piece is going to be Country Band March.
A treat here. Our first piece that we're going to open up with is with Country Band March, and I want to talk a little bit about it because it's really out there. So Country Band March was composed around 1903, 4 years after Charles Ives' graduation from Yale. Country Band March received no performances and only a pencil score sketch in the evidence that is known today. From the out-of-tune introduction to the pandemonium which you'll hear at the end of the piece. The Country Band March is a marvelous parody of the reality of performance by a country band back in the early 1900s. While the main march's theme is probably Ives' own, the march features an impressive list of quotations that include Arkansas's travel, Battle City of Freedom, British Grenadiers, the girl I left behind me, London Bridge, Marching Through Georgia, Massa's the Cold, Cold Ground, My Kentucky Home, Violet's Yankee Doodle, May Day Waltz, and Siempre Fidelis. There is rarely anything straightforward about the use of the material, and the tunes are subject to Ives' famous technique of poly everything. Poly everything, polytonal, meaning multiple ideas at the same time. So when you hear this piece, there's going to be 15, 16, 17 different tunes, possibly all at the same time, if not multiple stackings of them, and I don't know how many you'll actually recognize. The band is actually supposed to sound out of tune and in tune all at the same time, and you're either gonna really love it or think it's the weirdest thing you've heard, or just at the end of the day, just kind of go along with it. It is one of the hardest marches that anybody can actually learn, and the fact that the Wind Ensemble performed it at the Bands of America Concert Band Festival here a few weeks ago, and we'll be doing it for you tonight, is a testament to how extraordinary these musicians are. So we are going to start with Country Band March.
Thank you.
Did you recognize any of them?
I'm telling you, the piece is like, I don't know what he was on in the early 1900s, but I have so many questions, and when I die, he might be one of the composers I want to just ask to study that score and to try to teach it and for them to try to learn it. Has been the most insane project of our lives, but they did such a great job, and they make it sound easy, but there was a lot of work put behind that. So let's give them another round of applause for Country Band March. At this time, we want to recognize seniors that we have in this ensemble, and so we'll be calling you up here and make your way up here. First senior, please help me recognize Brandon Bliettoft. Our next senior, please help me welcome Alexis Garnica. Our next senior, please help me welcome Zachary Gifford. Our next senior, help me welcome Nathan Gomez. Also known as Shorty by his mom. Or that one curly trumpet player on Instagram. Please help me welcome our next senior, Sydney Leap. Brandon, I might have you actually go toward the microphone. Yeah, make room. Our next senior, please help me welcome Lauren Linford. My Barry Sax player, my favorite Barry Sax player this year. Please help me welcome Bodie Mullins. My one and only. Our next senior, please help me welcome Edward Nino. Please help me welcome our next senior, Nicholas Palomares. Yeah. You need a smile, your mom is gonna take pictures of you. Our next senior, please help me welcome Elric Pfeiffer. Yeah. Our next senior, help me welcome Shekinah Vale. Our next senior, help me welcome Thomas Vane. And last but not least, we did not forget about you. Please help me welcome our percussion senior, Samantha Clark. Let's give a big round of applause to our last group of seniors. And you can all take a seat. Thank you. Look how good looking they look. I told them they need to stay. I feel like I got a year and a half of my life robbed, and they're not really seniors. They're still juniors in my eyes, but the paper says they're seniors, so I can't fight with that. Our next set of awards, we're going to go ahead and get started as we call your name up. We want you to come up here. The Outstanding Woodwind Marcher Award is presented to a woodwind musician on the field who demonstrates high leadership qualities and incredible marching skills. She was consistently asked to demonstrate a variety of skills and always did it with a smile. She has been a true leader and a team player for the band. This year's Outstanding Woodwind Marching Award goes to Lauren Linford.
The following award is our Outstanding Brass Marcher. Now, earlier you saw us recognize Chase. However, we couldn't just pick one. This next recipient also was a core figure on the field. His athleticism on the field and high energy made him a standout. We would also like to recognize Mason Herr as our Outstanding Brass Marcher. The following award is given to a person who has worked incredibly hard in class. If she doesn't know something, she figures it out every time. Her ability to balance academics and the demand of this program is a testament to her demonstration and work ethic. She has been a tremendous asset, and we are thankful that she has been with us throughout her past 4 years. It is my pleasure to present our Outstanding Concert Percussion Award to Samantha Clark. And while she is still up here, our instrumental music boosters have also awarded Sam with a $500 Angel Quintero Music Scholarship Award. Congratulations, Sam. The following award is for our Outstanding Wind Ensemble member. Over the past few years, this individual has been a huge team player. His incredible musicianship and ability to move where he is best needed has made him a standout. We have used him as a tuba, trombone, and this past year as a euphonium player, and he has excelled in all areas, consistently making honor groups and representing our music program with high musical standards. This year's Wind Ensemble member goes to Brandon Blietto. He might be surprised. Brandon, when we graduate, what are we going to do? We're going to be
nice.
We're going to be nice. That's right. Life lessons. It goes on. And while he's still up here, the instrumental music boosters have also awarded Brandon with a $500 Outstanding Musician Scholarship Award. Our Outstanding Band Service Award goes to an individual that has gone above and beyond to help students, sections, staff, and literally anything the program needs. Let's also not forget what an incredible musician he has become. He is truly a walking figure of what it means to serve and to help your community grow. This year's Outstanding Band Service Award goes to Zachary Gifford. And while he is still here, I would also like to mention that Zachary Gifford is also one of our instrumental music program scholarship recipients, receiving a $500 scholarship for his outstanding service to the program. Congratulations, Zach. Let's give a big round of applause to these award winners. You got pictures, parents? All right. Up next, I want to welcome Nathan Gomez as our trumpet soloist for a trumpeter's lullaby. Wasn't he fantastic? Let's give another big round of applause to Nathan. I don't know if you guys can all guess where your parents are sitting at, but I could tell you. We're going to continue on with our last section of awards. This next award honors the life of past band member Caitlin Hook. As a trumpet player, Caitlin was known as a member who always brought happiness, smiles, and laughter to all who met her. This year's recipient is exactly that. He is the light of the saxophone section, and we are so excited to see him continue in music and to share his love and joy to others. This year's Caitlin Hook Memorial Award goes to Elric Pfeiffer. The following awards are a series of the Instrumental Division Awards. These awards are recognized at the national level. At last week's jazz concert, we recognized Elric Pfeiffer for the Woody Herman Award and Nathan Gomez for the Louis Armstrong Award. Go ahead and stand up to be recognized. They were recognized at last week's jazz concert. Tonight, we will continue to honor a few more students at this national prestigious level, starting off with the National School Marching Award. The National School Marching Award recognizes outstanding contributions on the field. It honors the musical contributions and dedication of student leaders whose examples inspire others. This student has been instrumental to the growth of our low brass section, specifically our euphonium and tuba section, both on and off the field. He has recruited and helped so many students in our program and has been such a positive role model. His marching contributions to his section and team have been indispensable. I would also like to thank him and recognize him as he will be joining the United States Marines in just a few short weeks. And we would like to thank him for his service. We have been honored to have him in our program and look forward to what the future has in store for him. This year's National School Marching Award goes to EJ Nino. The Director's Award for Band honors outstanding members in our music ensemble. This student participates in all aspects of the program. Over the past 4 years, she has always stepped up to the plate to help volunteer in as many ways possible. Even during the pandemic, she always found ways to help. And I don't know if it was that or she was trying to get out of her house. Whatever, we took it. At the young age of 11 years old, she began to attend and perform with her older brother in our symphony orchestra. She will have her final performance with the ensemble this coming Tuesday, and I believe she now holds the record as the longest student musician in our program. This year's Director's Award for Band goes to Sydney Leap. Quincy Jones Musicianship Award honors outstanding students for their creativity and musicianship. In his long musical career, Quincy Jones has done it all as a composer, arranger, performer, producer, and teacher. This student shares all of these qualities and has a boundless amount of energy and musical versatility. This year's Quincy Jones Musicianship Award goes to Gavin Tapp. In his long career, Leonard Bernstein made a huge mark on his musical world as a conductor, composer, and teacher. The Leonard Bernstein Award honors students whose musical contributions, dedication, and creativity set them apart as deserving of the highest recognition for their musical achievements. This recipient is an outstanding musician, making every honor group possible, including the Allstate Band, and fully participating in as many music ensembles, both in school as well as outside school. This year, the Leonard Bernstein Award is awarded to Sophia Brown. Patrick S. Gilmore Band Award is a beautiful award that honors outstanding high school band students and their musical achievements and commitment to the band. This year, this student participated in every possible ensemble they could be part of, from marching band, wind ensemble, symphony orchestra, jazz band, FMCMA honor band, honor jazz, and winning the top bass trombone chair in the state of California for the Allstate Band. This year's Patrick S. Gilmore Award goes to Oscar Olivares Jimenez. And our last award for the evening is the Sousa Award. The Sousa Award is the pinnacle of achievement in a high school band. This award recognizes superior musicianship and an outstanding dedication. This year's award recipient is nothing less than that. His musical contributions to all aspects of the program, including incredible dedication, and let's not forget his kind and loving nature, have helped sustain the level of excellence that is Clovis High School. And you currently just heard him play a really beautiful trumpet solo, and I gave him a week to learn that. So this year's John Philip Sousa Award goes to Nathan Gomez. Let's give a big round of applause to all of our final award winners. Thank you very much. We're so proud of you, and you can have a seat. The big plaques, they can take home, but they eventually do have to bring back before they check out. Those will go on our wall. Their name is engraved on all of them. And it's just something special to always think about them as years to come. Our final piece, we're going to end with a Stevie Wonder in concert. I think you will recognize all the pieces. And so we want to end with that. And I just want to say thank you so much for all of your support, not just this year, but over the past few years. And as we continue to move forward, and your constant support and contributions and dedication to your child and to the staff means everything to us. So thank you very much. This is Stevie Wonder in concert.
Actually, Mrs. Lozano, we have one more presentation. I'd like to invite our learning director, Mr. Balji Gill, to speak real quick.
All right, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, thank you very much for all the support that you have provided this program throughout the year. I have had the honor of being the learning director with these amazing kids and these amazing educators. So, Ms. Lozano, I want to present you some flowers. This is our nice moment. Every Tuesday, we meet, and we meet for about 2 hours, and we go at it. We just don't throw punches. But we do a lot of things in planning this program. You have no idea what this lady does to put together these programs, this band, and the amount of love, energy, and passion that she pours into this program, into your kids, on the eve of Mother's Day week. I'm thankful for Save Mart for having a bunch of flowers that I could pick up and bring in here. Usually they don't have it. I want to say thank you for everything you do on behalf of the Clovis High community. And we appreciate you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Let's give another big round of applause to our symphonic band, our concert percussion group, our clarinet choir, and our wind ensemble. Bravo, everybody. Thank you very much for coming. As soon as they clean the stage, they're all yours. Have a wonderful night and drive home safely.